What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to another Pokemon video. Today we're going to be talking about Pokemon Mystery Dungeon DX on the Nintendo Switch, and I was really excited for this game. I played the demo when it came out right after they announced it, and I have had a really good time playing the demo, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm still having a good time playing the actual game now that it is here. It came out last Friday, but I want to really give my kind of first impressions. I'm planning on fully reviewing this game, so if you're interested in seeing any of that, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell, because that video will probably come out in about a week when I finish the game, or at least the initial game, not the post-game stuff. So I will get that review up as soon as I can. It'll probably be next week, like I said, but I wanted to talk about some things that I've noticed, some changes that have been added to this game that really just have irked me and rubbed me the wrong way while playing this. So if you're unaware on what Pokemon Mystery Dungeon is, it is a game that originally came out on the DS as well as the Game Boy. It was Pokemon Blue and Red Rescue Team, and they were both the same game. One was just GBA, one was Nintendo DS, and they're really fun. It's basically you start the game, you take a quiz. The quiz will determine what Pokemon you are, and you then pick a partner and you will form a rescue team, which just goes into these randomly generated dungeons where you'll complete tasks such as delivering items, escorting Pokemon to other Pokemon, or rescuing Pokemon from the dungeon. And it's a really fun game, and they usually have some pretty interesting stories with some pretty interesting plots. And it's just, it's always been a franchise that I've really liked. It's one of the few Pokemon spinoff games that are actually, in my opinion, worth your time. And I was really looking forward to this one. Like I said, I played the demo, had a great time with it, so I pre-ordered this game immediately, and I have been having a good time with it, but some things have changed that just frustrate me. But first I want to talk about the good before I get into the negative kind of stuff. For example, the art style, I think it's really, really nice. I really do enjoy the art style of this game. It looks basically like it was hand-drawn and then colored in with colored pencil or like watercolor or something, and it's really cool, almost like a Winnie the Pooh type of art style, and I just really like it, and it really makes me happy because of Nintendo just seems to be doing, it's, and I know Nintendo isn't behind Pokemon necessarily, like it's Game Freak, but Nintendo games right now have had such unique art style. Like, let's just look at Link's Awakening for a second. That art style is so unique, and that is what I remember about that game. If someone says Link's Awakening, I'm thinking the art style, not the initial game itself. And that is kind of how I feel about Pokemon Mystery Dungeon on the Nintendo Switch. I'm thinking about this unique art style they've adopted for this game, and I really, really like it. Second, I really love the soundtrack. It is basically the exact same soundtrack from the original game, if not the exact same soundtrack. And that is just fantastic, because I love, and it's just such a nostalgia hit hearing these tracks again. And it's been something I've really enjoyed just loving going into the dungeons that I've played through when this game originally came out, which was when I was like 7 years old, and playing them again. And it's so cool hearing everything and experiencing this all over again in a new kind of style. And I know there are some other changes, like Mega Evolution and stuff, that has been added to this game. I am not quite far enough yet to have experienced or seen any of that stuff happen, but I am interested in seeing how that actually affects the gameplay and how you can progress through dungeons and stuff. But I want to start talking about some of the negatives, because there are a couple things that are just really, really irking me. So the first thing that's really bugging me is, maybe it's just me, but I feel like my partner is a lot more dumb than they used to be. In the past, they would always just follow you and then just kind of do their thing until an enemy got close enough. But now it seems my partner goes out of his way to go over and attack random mobs, and it's really starting to get on my nerves. And it seems he like goes after items and stuff on the ground more frequently. I can't remember. It's been so long since I played the other game, so maybe this is something that happened in the past, but it's really frustrating when my partner runs off when there's enemies closing in that I really just don't want to take the time to fight because it's getting tedious. And we end up having to fight those enemies because my partner decided he needed to go pick up those 5 gold coins on the ground across the room. It's really, really frustrating. And this next part is kind of the big one, is in the original games, if you just pressed A, you would do like a basic, like, you just kind of tackle. You just kind of like, your character would like move forward really quick, and then it would do damage, and then you'd come back, and you wouldn't use any moves. So it was a way to kind of conserve your power points, so you wouldn't like waste them all early on a dungeon. And that's not a thing anymore. You can only use your attacks. Now, if you press A in this game, it just picks the attack that they feel is smartest for the situation that you're in. And it's really kind of frustrating, especially in the mid game where I'm at right now, where you can like randomly get step on like an explosive tile and then die just out of nowhere. And I'm at a point where you can't go back to town and get items and stuff. So if you don't have anything in your storage, you're kind of getting screwed because these dungeons are getting progressively longer. So you don't have that option to just attack without using a PowerPoint. So by the time you're getting through these dungeons, you have no PowerPoints left. Your moves are done. There's no PP on any moves, and it makes it very, very difficult to traverse through these dungeons, especially because how RNG a lot of these dungeons elements are. Like I said, you can step on these random traps, like explosion traps, that do like 30 damage to you and your partner, and then you get O-code because you're half health when the first Pokemon encounters you. That's super frustrating, especially because you don't have any freaking items. That has been the biggest problem I have seen with this mid-game section of the initial story. And maybe it's just because I haven't done a ton of leveling. I haven't done a ton of side questing. Like, because I've played these games before, so I know I can do multiple quests at a time. I don't have to do one at a time. So I'm not leveling up a ton. I don't know if I'm just underleveled for where I'm at or what, but it is incredibly frustrating not having those PowerPoints. And you just don't have an option at that point. If you don't have PowerPoints, you can't attack. And that's super frustrating. And it's something I wish they would have never considered, like removing from the game. I really did like just having that ability, even if it was only like 10, 15, 20 damage based on your level. It was nice to have that option available to you. And then the final thing is, I just do genuinely think I am underleveled for this part of the game because I've done it all, I've played it all, I know what items to bring. So I think I just progressed really, really quick. And I got to this point, and my team's typing is not very good for the section that I'm at. So we're getting hit really hard. And the fact that our moves are just disappearing while we're trying to get through these dungeons, these 14, 15 floor dungeons, it's really frustrating. Really, really frustrating not having access to items to get my moves back so I can actually attack since I don't have that little jab that used to be in the game. So I think maybe just me being knowledgeable and having played this game in the past has made me underleveled for the situation that I'm in. But it's just it's poor game design at the end of the day. It's poor game design if that is the case. All in all, I am enjoying my time with this game. I am frustrated with some of the changes they're making, and I'm interested to see what the rest of the game has in store for me with the mega evolutions and stuff like that involving my Pokemon and everything. So, like I said earlier, I will be doing a full review over Pokemon Mystery Dungeon DX, whatever. It's such a long name. Pokemon Mystery Dungeon on the Switch, I will be doing a full review over in the next couple weeks. I'm hoping next week I can beat this game and then beat the initial story of this game. Like I said, I'm not going to cover the post-game stuff in the review, but beat the initial story of this game and then put out a review for it next week. That is the game plan at this time. But that is all I have for this kind of first impressions video. I hope you guys like it. And if you did, be sure to leave a like and smash that subscribe button for more videos like this in the future. Be sure to share the video with your friends. Let's grow this community here on the channel. Speaking of community, we have a community Discord. We're over there talking Pokemon. We're talking trading and a whole bunch of stuff. If you like Pokemon, you'll like this Discord server. So check me out there if you're at all interested. All my other social media should be on screen here. So if you're interested in keeping up with me or the channel or the Twitch stream, follow me there. Check me out there. But like I said, that is all I have for you guys today. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next video.